There is no better feeling than having a bit of free time. Time to do activities you want to do. Activities you like and do frequently no matter what. How about an afternoon walk around town to really take your mind off? Or a relaxing day swimming in the pool, refreshing your body or thoughts? What can you tell me about a funny afternoon playing soccer with your friends? Or maybe fishing in the sea alone or with your special someone? Can you imagine going on a nature trail, becoming one with the Mother Nature? Is there anything better than relaxing next to the river in a sunny day? Try something like surfing, playing video games or watching movies. Move your body and activate yourself. Simple present. Interrogative form. What do you do? I play soccer. I don't run. When we talked about habits, daily routines or activities we usually do, we need to use the simple present. Today, we will focus on the interrogative form, which is used in such a way as to get or give information about our daily activities. What does he do? He reads books. He doesn't play basketball. Remember that we've got two answers, positive form and negative one. It's really important to add an S to the third person, he, she, it, when you use an affirmative answer.
How to make a question. ¿Cómo hacer una pregunta?
Here, it's completely necessary to use the auxiliary verb do, and it depends on the person you are going to talk about.
Aquí, es completamente necesario usar el verbo auxiliar do, y este depende de la persona de la cual vayas a hablar.
So, if you refer to I, you, we, they, you will use do at the beginning of the question.
Entonces, si tú te refieres a I, you, we, they, tendrás que usar do al inicio de la pregunta.
On the other hand, if you talked about the third person, you will write does at the beginning of the question.
Por otro lado, si tú hablas acerca de una tercera persona, tendrás que escribir does al inicio de la pregunta. Si pudiéramos describir una estructura del presente simple en su forma interrogativa, esta quedaría de la siguiente manera. Observen el diagrama. Lo primero que tienen que escribir es do o does, dependiendo del sujeto que se encuentra en segunda posición. Recordemos que do lo vamos a utilizar con los sujetos I, you, we, they, mientras que does lo vamos a utilizar con las terceras personas. He, she, it.
Look at the examples. Observa los ejemplos.
Does she study English?
Yes, she does.
No, she doesn't.
Do they swim in the pool?
Yes, they do.
No, they don't.
Do you play with your brother?
Yes, I do.
No, I don't.
Does he run 100 meters?
Yes, he does.
No, he doesn't.
Congratulations. Felicitaciones. Now you know how to ask for information.
Ahora ya sabes cómo pedir información.
Activity number one. Actividad número uno. Find the mistake. Write the following sentences on your notebook and identify the mistake.
Encuentra el error. Escribe los siguientes enunciados en tu cuaderno e identifica el error. Pon mucha atención a cada uno de ellos. Escríbelos y señala cuál es el error que tienen. Puedes usar lápices de colores.
And here you've got the answers. Do you play video games? Does he ride a bicycle? Does Margaret eat chocolate? Do we watch television? Do you like reading books?
Activity number two. Actividad número dos. Complete the sentences with do or does. Completa los enunciados con do o con does. Puedes escribir los enunciados en tu cuaderno y realizar la actividad ahí. Tómate tu tiempo.
And here you've got the answers.
Aquí tienes las respuestas.
Con esto damos por concluidas las clases del presente simple en sus tres formas: affirmative form, negative form, interrogative form. Forma afirmativa, forma negativa y forma interrogativa.
Thank you for watching the video.
Muchas gracias por ver el video. Recuerden que si tienen alguna duda, siempre pueden dejar su comentario en la parte de abajo.
No olviden dejar su like y suscribirse al canal, ya que para nosotros es muy importante. Recuerden que nosotros somos Frijoles con Arroz.